Okay, so the next thing we're going to talk about is multiplying fractions. So for the most part, people do prefer to multiply and divide fractions in comparison to adding and subtracting fractions. There's a lot more steps involved when you add and subtract fractions, not as much when you multiply or divide fractions. So the book definition on how to multiply fractions is right here. It says when you have fraction A over B and you're multiplying it by fraction C over D, you're going to get A times C over B times D. So in a nutshell, it's pretty much telling you multiply numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. Right? Top times top, bottom times bottom. But you just need to always remember when it does come to multiplying fractions. So your first step will be to actually multiply the fractions, but your second or your last step, regardless what you're doing with fractions, is going to be to simplify the fractions. You always need to make sure that you simplify fractions in the end. Doesn't matter what you're doing with them. So when it comes to this here, so we're going to start with example A here. We have 2 over 5 times 1 over 3. Okay, so step 1, multiply fractions. Go straight across. 2 times 1 is a 2 over 5 times 3 is a 15. Okay, it's really that simple. Just multiply straight across. Then when you actually get your answer here, it's not exactly your final answer. You do need to go through the check and make sure, is this fraction simplified? So take a look at 2, take a look at 15. Does a 2 and a 15 have anything in common? Well, it doesn't, right? I mean, the only thing that goes into a 2 is a 1 and a 2. You can't use the 1, and a 2 does not go into 15. They have nothing in common. So this would be our final answer for that example. So example B down here is 1 over 10 times 5 over 6. All right, so multiply straight across. 1 times 5 is 5 over 10 times 6 is 60. Take a look. Can this fraction be simplified? And here it can. Because if I'm looking at a 5 and a 60, they do have something in common. Remember, if a number ends in a 0 or a 5, it is divisible by 5. So I know they at least have a 5 in common. So I'm going to use the method of dividing out. So 5 and a 60 has a 5 in common. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide out a 5 from the numerator and the denominator. So 5 divided by 5 is a 1. And 60 divided by 5 is a 12. Always do take a look at your final answer here just to make sure you didn't, or you weren't off by something, you didn't happen to make a mistake. 1 and a 12 does not have anything in common, so that means that would be my final answer for that one, so 1/12. Taking a look at example C. So example C, we have mixed numbers here. We have 3 and 3/4 times 1 and 3/4. So the main thing that you need to know about multiplying mixed numbers is that you need to convert them first. So when you're dealing with mixed numbers here, convert first, then multiply, then simplify. Okay, so just a slightly extra step right here. You need to make sure that you convert them to improper fractions. So that's our first step, so let's go ahead and take care of that. So converting 3 and 3/4, so you take the denominator times the whole number, 4 times 3 is 12, plus the numerator. So 12 plus 3 is a 15, and you put that over the same denominator, so it was a 4, it's going to stay a 4. So again, 4 times 3 is 12, plus 3 is 15, so 15 over 4. Times our second fraction, so 1 and 3/4, so denominator times whole number, 4 times 1 is a 4, plus 3 is a 7, and put that over your denominator. So I have a 7/4 there. So we're done with the converting. Go ahead and multiply. 15 times 7 is 105 over 4 times 4, which is 16. Okay, so typically rule of thumb when it comes to fractions, as if it starts as a regular fraction, it needs to end as a regular fraction. If it starts out as a mixed number, your answer needs to be in a mixed number. So we need to take our answer here and we need to convert that back to a mixed number. So again, the way that we do that is we divide. I'm going to bring that division up over here. So we're going to do 105 divided by 16. So when we do 105 divided by 16, 16 goes into 105 six times. When we multiply that, 6 times 16 is a 96. So when we subtract here, right, we get a 9. So the way that we write our the way that we write our mixed number, 6 is our whole number, so that's going to be a 6. Our remainder is our numerator, and our denominator stays the same. So here we're going to have a 6 and 9 sixteenths. Do always take a look at your fraction portion of that to make sure that that cannot be simplified. But a 9 does not have anything in common with a 16, so we are done there. So our final answer here would be a 6 and 9 sixteenths. So just remember, when it does come to mixed numbers, you must convert. You cannot just do 3 times 1 and 3 fourths times 3 fourths. That is not going to work. So make sure you do convert them to improper fractions, multiply, and then convert back. Okay, so now we're going to be dividing fractions. So here I have the book definition here for dividing fractions. So it says when you have fraction A over B and you're dividing it by fraction C over D. Well, what you're going to do is notice a fraction A is still the same thing, A over B, A over B. The things that change is division symbol changes to multiplication. And the second fraction, notice how it is now flipped, right? So what you need to remember, keep, change, flip. Keep, change, flip. Right, the first fraction stays the same, change from division to multiplication, and flip the second fraction. So that is your rule for dividing fractions. So your steps typically when you divide fractions is, well, step one, use the rule. You need to use the division rule to change it from a division problem to a multiplication problem. That's really all this division rule does. It doesn't solve it for us yet. All it does is take it from division and change it all down to a multiplication problem. So that after we use the rule, then what we do is we're now going to multiply. And then our last step is always to simplify. We always need to get in the mode of simplifying regardless what we're doing with fractions. So step one, use the rule. Step two, multiply. Step three, simplify the fraction. So taking a look at our examples here, our first example, 7/8 divided by 2/3. First thing we're going to do is use the rule. So again, keep, the first one's going to stay the same, change, division and multiplication, and flip the second fraction. All right, so now that we've used the rule, multiply. Remember, when you multiply straight across. So 7 times 3 is a 21 over 8 times 6. Eight times two is a 16. Take a look at your fraction to see if anything could be simplified. Do we have anything in common with a 21 and a 16? I don't see anything in common. And rule of thumb here when it comes to a fraction, this is an improper fraction, but if your problem starts as a fraction, keep it as a fraction. If it starts as a mixed number, end it as a mixed number. So I'm gonna just say that this is my final answer here. But do pay attention to your instructions for your problem, just to be sure what is it specifically asking you to leave your answer as. So always do be aware of that. Example B, 12 over 7 divided by 3. First things first, when it comes to an example like this, anytime you have a whole number, when you're dealing with fractions, turn it into a fraction. Here I have a 3. I can turn a 3 into a fraction simply by putting it over 1, right? 3 over 1 is the same thing as a 3. And go ahead and do so, just so you don't get confused on what to do with a number or anything like that. Make it a fraction, that way there's just no confusion, okay? So anytime you see a whole number, always put it over 1 and then continue with what you're doing. So first things first, we need to use the rule here. So keep the 12 over 7. change that to multiplication, flip this over so this is now a 1/3. So that when I'm multiplying across, I have 12 times 1, which is a 12, over 7 times 3, which is 21. Then we need to simplify. Now, some of you at this point might already be thinking, before we even did the multiplication, if you're thinking at this point that we can go ahead and simplify, you can cancel out this 12, you can make that 12 with 3 times a 4 and cancel here. If that's the way that you're comfortable with simplifying, by all means, go ahead and do so. When it comes to small enough numbers like this, I tend to just multiply through and simplify in the end. But again, when it comes to math, sometimes there's multiple ways of doing the same thing. Do what is most comfortable for you. So if you didn't understand what I just said about doing that, disregard that bit. We're multiplying here. 12 times 1 is 12. 7 times 3 is a 21. Take a look at your final answer here to see if you have anything in common, which we do. A 12 and a 21 has a 3 in common, right? So I'm going to use the method of dividing out. Right, so because I have a 3 in common, I can divide a 3 out from the numerator, from the denominator, and doing so there, 12 divided by 3 is a 4, and 21 divided by 3 is a 7. A 4 and a 7 doesn't have anything in common, so that's my final answer there. Okay. C, right? So example C here, I have a mixed number example here. So do remember, when it comes to mixed numbers, the first thing that you have to do is to convert them into improper fractions, right? So let's convert, right? So here, 4 times 6 is a 24, plus 3 gives us a 27. Keep that over 4. Divided by 10 times 1 is 10. Plus 1 is 11, and keep that over 10. So step 1, convert. Step 2, use the rule. So the rule tells us this will be 27 over 4. Change that to multiplication and flip the second fraction. Okay, so the only thing left to do here is to actually multiply and simplify. So I'm going to bring this down here. 27 times 10, well, that's 270. 4 times 11 is 44. So we have slightly big numbers here, but remember, because our problem started as a mixed number, it needs to end as a mixed number. So I'm going to erase some of this space up here so I can use that to convert that back. So we have 270 divided by 44. So remember, to take an improper fraction back to a mixed number, you need to divide top divided by bottom. So 44 goes into 270. Let's see what, 1, 2, 3, 4, possibly 5 times. All right, so 44 goes into 270 6 times. So 6 times 44, I think that's 264 there. When we multiply that, so when we do the subtraction here, we get a remainder of 6. So that our final answer here, so 6 is our whole number, this remainder of a 6 is our numerator, and we put that over our denominator. Always check when you convert to make sure that your fraction cannot be simplified. Ours can. Notice they're both even numbers there, but this might be a little easier to simplify than this down here, right? So they're both an even number, so I know at least a 2 works, so I'm going to divide by 2. Drop that 6 down. We're not dividing the 6 by 2, only the fraction portion here. 6 divided by 2 is a 3, and 44 divided by 2 is a 22. So our final answer for this problem would be 6 and 3 22s. So there you go, dividing fractions.